Hi again, everyone. Adrian Hughes here with Hughesy Tech, and tonight we're taking a look at the FEI T5e 4K action camera. So tonight we're doing something a little different, and we are taking a look at an action camera, which is going to be used as a dash camera in my car. So this review sample was kindly provided to me by the good folks over at gearbest.com. That's gearbest.com, your source for all things electronics, clothing and miscellaneous novelty items. They are a great place with a wide selection of items for sale at fantastic prices. So I do recommend that you check them out. I have shopped with them on numerous occasions and have not had any issues. Shipping and postage has been very fast and the items have been fantastic. So I'll leave a link in the description below to this FEI T5e action camera, and we'll just get into the unboxing here now. So if we take a look at the bottom of the box, it runs into the specs here. This is the black version that I have here, as you'll see in a second, and we have the package contents outlined to us on the back here. Now this is a 4K action camera that records at 30 frames per second, 2.5K at 60 frames per second, 1080p at 120 frames per second, and 720p at 240 frames per second. So that is super slow motion for those artistic, cool looking shots. And we have still image resolutions of 16, 12, 8.3 and 5 megapixel still images depending on what video mode is chosen. And we have a f2.8 lens here, a 7 glass element, and a field of view of 170 degrees to give you that wide fisheye look on your videos. Now this is IP68 rated to a depth of 60 meters, so this does include a waterproof housing, and you should be able to go diving with this with no issues at all. And it does support Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, so you can use the Wi-Fi to transfer your videos to your phone or other smart device and use the app where you can use special effects or look at your footage change settings on the camera itself. Now this does have a built-in 2-inch TFT LCD screen of 960 by 540 resolution. There is no touchscreen on this device, but that shouldn't be an issue since it is an action camera. You'll be using the physical buttons quite a bit. And finally, it does have micro SD card support up to 64 gigabytes. And it does recommend that you use the newer UHS One U3 micro SD memory cards to enable smooth writing to the memory card itself because of the high bit rate of 4K videos. So that's it for the box. It is a simple cardboard box, but nice presented. Bit of a shiny FEI logo there. Now we open up this box here, and we are greeted by the user guide, quick start guide here. Does outline what is in the box and just the functions of the camera itself when it comes to the buttons or whatnot. Does come in a few other languages like Chinese, German, Russian, I believe. And if we take a look inside the box, we have the FEI T5e camera here. And we have the accessories right here. So we'll just put that aside for a second, and we will take a look at the accessories and what's included with this action camera. So this is the wiping cloth. Wipe any dust marks or whatnot off your device, any smudges. A 360 degree rotating mount there, so you can bolt that onto the bottom of the camera. The mount that goes with the buckle mount there, pin to keep secure. A micro USB to USB A end cable. Spare adhesive mounts, as you can see there. A simple mount there with FEI branding for the bike or helmet. And the spare battery here. So this is rated at 1100 milliamp hours, which should give a runtime of about 80 minutes or so, which is what VI has stated on their website. And we'll be putting that to the test to see how long this particular dash cam records for. But yeah, it's great to see a additional battery included in the box here, which is always handy and always a good idea with a action camera or any other electronic device, actually, to be honest. Now we'll just take the foam backing there off, and as you can see, we have the VI right here. It is contained in its waterproof housing, as you can see, nicely secured there to stop any water, dust, or anything else, any ingress, and stop that coming in. As you can see there, it says open, so it's nicely secured. We just push that back there, take the other clip, and then we can take the VI T5e action camera out of its protective waterproof housing. And here is the little guy here. So this is the black version. There is a silver version also available, and it does have a nice stainless steel pattern here. We'll take a look around the camera itself in a minute, but I'll just give you a quick rundown of the other specs. This is a Sony IMX117 sensor of 1 over 2.3 inches CMOS sensor. Now this is the same sensor that is being used in the GoPro Hero 3 or 4, I believe, one of them. And it is running on the Ambarella A12 LS75 chipset. So this is a true 4K camera. I repeat, a true 4K camera. There are a lot of 4K cameras out there, 4K with the fingers there, as you can see, that aren't actually real 4K. They are either interpolated, so they have jacked up the image size of the sensor because it can't handle it, or it is doubling the frames or whatnot. So it's either interpolation or using any other tricks to jack up the reported image quality to 4K. Now this is, as I said, true 4K. I have checked it out myself on PC and have verified that the video quality is true 4K. Now, I believe that is it for the specs here. It is a 16 megapixel images there. 540p screen, as I said, and it weighs 58 grams. So let's power this guy on and we'll see what we're in for. As you can see, we'll just, before we get into the menu there, we'll just take a quick tour of the camera itself. Do have the status LED, as it did blink on there when I turned it on with its little jingle. A Wi-Fi status LED, power on and off button, the lens itself. If we take a look at the side there, we do have a micro HDMI output to your laptop or TV. A micro USB, which is used for charging and data connectivity, and the micro SD memory card, which I have put a Alexa one in there. We do have the Wi-Fi on and off button up the top here, and this is also used as an OK button, and the front also doubles as a menu button, as you'll see very soon as we walk through the menu. This is just going up and down in the menus and to trigger certain functions on and off. You can see microphones on the side there, and on the bottom we have another status LED. We have a 1/4 inch standard camera tripod mount, and we have the battery door here. As you can see, I can just push up, slide out, and there it is there. We have the tab here to make easy removal of the battery itself. Just pull up on that and it slides out very easily. So let's take a look at the menu itself. Now this is a 2-inch TFT LCD screen. No touch, but as it's a action camera, it shouldn't matter too much. As you can see on the top here, forgive my camera there with the glare. Let's see if we can get a good angle. If not, I will have to put it on the actual down here. Okay, now, as you can see there, we do have the camera itself, and it is recording at, I believe, 960p at 30 frames per second. As you can see there, so 1280, 960p, 4:3 aspect ratio, and super fine mode. Up the top here, we have the microphone icon. So if I press the up button there, you can see it toggles it on and off. Got the battery status icon there. And we have a 32 gigabyte memory card in there. It's telling me that 29.7 gigs are available. Now, if I press this power button at the front here, it'll cycle me through the modes there. This is the camera mode, as you can see at the top there. We were previously in the video mode. Press it again, video playback, photo playback, and in the actual menu itself. So with the video resolutions, we do have a lot on offer, a heck of a lot. So anything that you can think of is pretty much here. 200 frames per second, 120, 60, 30. We have super view modes on here, which just adds a little bit more to the frame at the top and the bottom. And we have the 40K at 30 frames, 25, 2.5K, I believe. Then there's 2K. This is a bit of a strange one. Between full HD and 2K. There's full HD at up to 120 frames per second. 720p does 240. And 4K does 30. So no 60 frames per second. This chipset doesn't handle it, I believe. Only the recently announced Ambarella chipset supports it, and I think it's the Xiaomi Yi 2 or whatnot, is the only camera that supports 4K 60 frames per second recording video in the world at the moment. So you can just press the top button there and it'll select it, the Wi-Fi button, and we'll cycle through the other menu options here. We've got the still image quality, 16, 14, 12, 8.3, and 5, all the way down to 3. Video quality, super fine, fine, and normal. It does change the bitrate itself. We do have photo quality. Sorry, it should be similar, super fine, fine, and normal. Quick capture, EIS. Electronic image stabilization. This camera does not have optical image stabilization, as that would increase the bulk and leave it more susceptible to damage, because having any moving parts in here, obviously in an action camera, which you're using for action purposes, might not be a good idea. Dual files, video stamp, so you can leave the stamps there, much as on any other camera device. Photo stamp, time-lapse video, so you can take time-lapse videos on this device. Loop record, so you can record in loops, 1, 2, 3, 5. Why not self-timer, pretty self-explanatory. Photo burst, same there. Time-lapse photo, same deal as for the time-lapse videos. And we come to what we'll be using for our review samples later on. The auto DVR, so you can turn that on and this will record as a dash cam. Delay off, which will be used for the dash cam there. TV mode, sorry, got TV mode, it should be 50 or 60 hertz, yep. Sorry, that's 30 frames per second for NTSC and 23.9724 frames per second for PAL, depending where you are in the world. And what your preference is, light frequency, auto 50, 60 hertz, on-screen display, yes please. So that does display all the items on the top of the camera there, so you can see what you're recording out or what mode you're in or whatnot. Auto shutdown, screen off, so you can tell it to turn the screen off after a minute or 30 seconds or whatever you want. Status LED, so this does turn on the LEDs as you wish, so you can go 1, 2, 3, or 4, so that'll tell it to either turn on the Wi-Fi LED or the Wi-Fi and the status one, or that one as well, the other status on the bottom there, and the other ones over here. So there's quite a lot of options there. Wi-Fi LEDs, same deal there. Turn on and off TV out. Can tell it to output to TV, beep, keep the beep on. Microphone volume, so this is great. You can vary the microphone volume and the sensitivity on this camera. The sharpness, again, of photos and video. Auto white balance, so you've got daylight, incandescent, cloudy, flash, fluorescent, and other standards, water, outdoor, or auto. EV value, exposure value, scene mode. Again, normal flash, sight, night, sports, landscape. Effect mode, art, sepia, negative, or black and white. Got ISO, so you can sort, change different values. Goes all the way up to 1600 for those super slow exposure times there for very dark situations. Metering, center, multi, or spot. So you can tell it where to center in when you are doing the images. Time setup, and then we've got all the miscellaneous admin options. Date, format, language, pretty self-explanatory. Bluetooth pair, Wi-Fi on or off. So that's fantastic for the accompanying app that goes with this camera, which you can see live footage, transfer video and photos directly to your phone or other Wi-Fi device, or play around with several other options. Wi-Fi SSID and password, again, same for connecting to your phone or wireless access point, whatnot. Format, default setting, and here is the firmware version. So we are using the February 11th, 2017 firmware version that was pushed a couple of weeks ago. Now, that's going to do it for this video, pretty much. I'm going to have a quick look, see if there's anything else that I have missed here. Does record an MP4, H.264, no H.265. It's probably a bit early for that anyway, and probably a bit taxing on the processor, I would say. H.265 isn't that widespread in adoption, regardless, anyway. Like I said, 58 grams for the camera. Waterproof housing takes it up another 100 grams or whatnot, but still not very heavy at all. So that's it for this, a quick look at the Fei T5e 4K action camera. Now, this is available on gearbest.com. I will leave the link in the description below so that you can check it out for yourself, and if you do like it, then go ahead and purchase it from those fantastic guys over there, those guys and girls over at gearbest.com. This is a very handy alternative and a much cheaper alternative to the GoPro cameras, and from all accounts, from what I've read and seen, this does perform just as well as those cameras at a fraction of the cost. So this will be interesting to see how it fares, not only as an action camera in its native setting, but as a car dash cam. The first 4K footage that I'll be recording in a dash camera. So I have recorded before in maximum 2K using the Vofo A119, and it'll be very interesting to see how this Fei performs here. And much like Vofo, they do have great support. I've reached out and talked to some various reps, and they have got back to me pretty quickly. They do keep their firmware up to date, very well laid out and very easy to see, to look for what you're looking for on their website. So hands off, very commendation to them. over at FEI. So once again, do check this camera out, the link below in the description, and I will be uploading video samples very soon and photos too. Do check out my full review over at Dash Cam Talk Forum very, very soon. You'll be seeing that in the next week or so. And thanks again for watching. If you like it, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Leave any comments or any questions that you may have about this device. And yeah, thanks again for watching. And I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye for now.